is very disliked now in Los Angeles is Mayweather, because he seems to defeat the local heroes, meaning the Mexicans, all the time. And they've dug up another one here, good looking Aceves, with the 30 wins on his record, so he knows what it's about. But Mayweather's turned into a really good, as they call it here, super lightweight, or we call it light welterweight, 10 stone division. Division that Terry Marsh was able to win the championship. And judging on this form, maybe it's just as well that Marsh is no longer active, because Roger Mayweather can really bang at this weight. And there he's just trying it for size, got a lot of reach, maintains the power when the arms are fully extended. American referee Chuck Hassett, and of course the usual judges, scheduled for 12, WBC version. Along a bit late in his career, really, Mayweather, to win the championship. He had a brother who was a champion, and now Jesse Reed is working his corner. He's the man who trained Frank Tate, who's champion, to fight Tony Simpson in Stafford. Good old pro, this Jim, isn't he, Mayweather?
Yeah, he has a very relaxed style, but at the same time, he's very sharp in his movements, but his shoulders are always nice and relaxed. There you go. That punch just shot out of its own accord there.
Well, he looked still shocked by that, doesn't he, the Mexican? Gets the mandatory eight. Now he's probably going to say, oh dear, I thought I might win this fight, but the Black Mamba struck again. That's hasn't silenced the Mexican support in this crowd, but I think it stunned them almost as much as the challenger, not quite. Minute to go in the opening round then, and Mayweather stamping his authority already. And the Mexican obviously getting encouragement now to come fighting back, and he'll lead to. Mayweather's camp really plot everything. They look at the challenges, they see videotapes, they work out what's going to happen, and they really get their man going for this, as they proved with Frank Tate when he was take his time when he fought Tony Simpson, and even train late at night to coincide with the same time that he was going to be in the ring with Simpson. Explosive stuff at the start then from Mayweather. So as he sits down there, Savers is, well, they may be saying, what happened to you? Well, it doesn't get caught cold so much, because he came in a bit warmed up for it, but he didn't realise, I don't think, that Mayweather could do the business so quickly. I don't know whether you could say looks degenerate. Find out, Jim, in this replay.
Mayweather so relaxed, he didn't wind the punch up. The punch just seemed to shoot out of its own accord. Caught Savers a little bit high.
Now there's Jesse Reed there, bending down there, as I say, giving the instructions. Is Reed's a good fighter, he was a top class amateur, and he defeated some good men too. Into the second, and it looks as though Mayweather's going to enjoy his reign now as the WBC 10 stone champion. He must be a frustrating man to fight, this Mayweather. The arms are the length, Jim, and then when you get near him, he nails you hard.
Yeah, and he's very off his mark too, as an opponent comes in close to him. In the first round, he scored the knockdown, he hardly took a worthwhile punch in the turn, and really got his tools sharpened up and really started looking the part. Yeah, Savis has been doing the right thing. He's trying to come forward to get close, but he simply can't get close to do any damage.
One-two punch is definitely the champion's favoured one. The left hand comes out, there it is again, just missing the chin. Tries to be a bit where May Mayweather with the right hand. He's had to save it for the right time, but he hasn't quite connected yet. A bit too early for him. First round, yes, but he hasn't been able to do it at the start of the second. An accomplished fighter. He noticed that left jab, and then he turned it into a hook at the same time, the second punch. Many about it this way, Jim, and I fancy too strong with Mayweather. He's got it on his own at the moment.
Yeah, well, he's learned his trade, he's taken his time about it, and he's really become an accomplished fighter. He doesn't make too many mistakes, he's very difficult to hit, and throws very sharp punches himself.
Notice the power he gets in when he can shorten that right hand, when he gets the opponent coming in. That's the time to watch it. And certainly the opponent's got to. Fight base now in Las Vegas, which is one of the busiest boxing towns in the world. Originally from Grand Rapids, Michigan, Mayweather. Haven't seen much of a saviour, so I really don't know too much of his form, but it stands up though, his record, and well rated to get this shot. And coming up then for the end of the second, Jesse Reed there. He got a bit right hand happy, and Eddie Aliano on the outside of the rope just looking across there again, checking on the other corner, because apparently his nose has busted up a bit. It's very comfortable about it, although he's sitting in the back seat of a car on a joyride. So coming out for the third, and that's one of the jobs for good corner men, is to be looking to the other corner to see what's going on and to encourage their man. That, well, he didn't need a lot of encouraging, but apparently the Mexican's damaged around the nose. And it really looks all over bar the shouting now for the champion. But Mexican fighters, well, they just can't quit, particularly when they fight in Los Angeles with this very hostile crowd. Good sense seemed to me to be spoken in the corner there, Jim.
Yeah, it was good advice he was given. But Aceva seems to be trying to knock him out of his stride here. I think if Aceva settles down, then that suits Mayweather. He's tried at the beginning of this round to hustle him a little bit. But just as I'm speaking now, it's not working.
No, I don't think the Mexican has got the ammunition to beat this fella. He's actually measuring him. Look at that for that right hand. He's got a bit of a hunter's patience too, Mayweather. He really digs like a middleweight, this fella. That's it. 11 stone 6. Oh, and a delay there, and he'll go down from that. It almost poleaxed him, that punch. He just completely lost his senses. He's getting a longer than 10 count because he's waited for Mayweather to go to the corner, but no, he's going to count him out here. And he's looking on the ropes to say, what hit me, or will somebody take the number of that lorry that just ran over me? Now, there he is, Jesse Reed saying to Mayweather, well, that's what I was telling you.